Hello friends, let's discuss this week's current affairs. And the first question is about which of the following wetlands in India have recently been it should be more than one, because here the answer is more than one, so it should be have recently been accorded the Ramsar site tag. And now Ramsar is a convention on wetlands. Now, what's a wetland? We'll come to Ramsar in a while, but let's look at what's a wetland. I have put this definition that comes from straight from the Ramsar, you know, convention website. The, you know, it uses a broad definition of wetlands. It includes everything that is watered. You see that? You know, there's water in lakes, rivers, underground aquifers, basically, swamps, marshes, wet grasslands. You name a thing, basically, even if it's human made, you know, not just natural, if it's covered with water, it's inundated in water, then ladies and gentlemen, it's a wetland. Now, wetlands are greatly important for, you know, animal life, plant life, and that, my friends, includes people like us. When we say animal life, we are included in that. Now, see, the Ramsar Convention was launched in 1971. Let me say 1971, this is a place, it's named after a place in Iran. What is it? Iran. Now, Iran, this is on the Caspian Sea. As you know, Caspian Sea is an inland sea that borders northern Iran. So, in 1971, major nations met here and they kind of thrashed out an agreement that kind of said that, okay, let's identify certain, you know, wetlands that we need to protect. And that's how this convention had come about. Recently, three more wetlands in India have been added to this list. The first two are in Tamil Nadu. I wouldn't even know how to pronounce them because I'm from, you know, I'm a South Indian. From Telangana, but if you look at these choices here, I would say Karuveli, Nanjarayan. So if my pronunciation is incorrect, kindly forgive me. Tawa Reservoir, of course, is in Madhya Pradesh. So the first two are in Tamil Nadu and the last one, Tawa Reservoir, is in Madhya Pradesh. Okay. Now, let me add one more point here. The World Wetlands Day is observed on 2nd February. What is that? 2nd February. Now, the World Wetlands Day is observed on 2nd February because on this day in 1971, the Ramsar Convention was approved. Okay? So, on 2nd February 1971, the World Wetlands Day is observed in, you know, to celebrate the signing of the convention named, the agreement named Ramsar Convention on Wetlands. Fair? Shall we go from here? And by the way, which country has the maximum number of wetlands? United Kingdom. I think it's about 175. I learned this from the, you know, the Ramsar website, nothing more, you know, not beyond this. Which film won the Best Feature Film Award at the 70th National Film Awards? Ladies and gentlemen, we had discussed this question in the previous week, and we found that the answer to this question is Aattam, which is a Malayalam film. Now, each of these choices here could give us some dope. Kantara won two awards. One was film providing wholesome and best feature film providing wholesome family entertainment, that is Kantara, and that's a Kannada film. It stars Rishabh Shetty. He was also the director. Rishabh Shetty also won the Best Actor Award for this film. So Best Actor, Rishabh Shetty for Kantara. Unchai, Best Director, Suraj Barjatia. This is the same guy who made Maine Pyar Kiya, Hum Aapke Hai Kaun, all that. Coming to the choices 3 and 4, these two play films, the third film here, I mean the Kutch Express mentioned here. Kutch Express is a Gujarati film, Tiruchitrabalam, originally a Tamil film, but it has been dubbed into Telugu. I have watched it in Telugu. It's also there in Kannada and Malayalam. The actresses in this jointly won the Best Actor Award, Best Actress Award. Let's look at the choice three, the Kutch Express. For this, for a role in the Kutch Express, Manasi Parekh, P-A-R-E-K-H, Nithya Menon, M-E-N-O-N, or M-E-N-E-N, that's how she writes. For a role in Tiruchitrabalam, they won the Best Actress Award. So Nithya Menon and Manasi Parekh. According to a survey report, which country accounts for the highest share of FPI? Now, what's FPI? Foreign portfolio investment or foreign portfolio investor. So foreign portfolio investing in India, highest share one, but exactly is this. See, when a country invests money to set up a business, that would be called foreign direct investment. So it actually sets up an entire business of its own in India, or it could be a joint venture, but it brings in money as capital. Now in FPI, what happens is a foreign company would come in, set up, it would buy shares, invest in mutual funds, which is indirect way of investing shares. So you have mutual funds, they buy bonds, debt bonds, income bonds, whatever kinds of bonds. So they buy bonds without taking ownership, without actually, getting a share in the management, basically. So FPI investing is more, foreign portfolio investment is more of, buying shares. Like you buy shares, something similar happens here. Here, a foreign company is buying shares. Okay. Now, I went through this report and I found that in India, the highest number of companies come from the US. That's about 3,457. So 3,457. So let's make it 3,456. It's easier to remember that way. So the total number of FPIs registered with the SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, they have to register with the SEBI that, look, we have come to India, we are an FPI, we want to invest in your stock market, buy, in your mutual funds and all. So there were about, the latest report says, SEBI report talks of about 11,400 FPIs. I'm rounding this number off. Okay. So 11,400 kind of number. And of this, FPIs from US account for about 3,456. I told you it's a, number. I from 3,457, I made it 3,456. Luxembourg has about 1,300 FPIs registered in India with SEBI. Canada, 804. That's about the top three. Okay. And please know that together, all these 11,400 odd FPIs have invested in shares worth, can you believe, $840 billion. Yes. I was surprised when I read the number. 840, 830 number, basically. Anything above 8, and see, this is, let's make it 825, round figure, 825. Yeah, $825 billion they have invested in Indian shares, mutual funds, bonds and all. Now, this is current year number, okay? At the end of financial year 24, that is the bygone financial year. But, in financial year 23, the one that ended last year, on March 31st last year, the total FPI assets were about, in India, were about $580 billion, 580. Now, how much, what's the number? Now, the number is, 825. So, from 580 to 825, the number has gone up significantly. In 1 year, they have invested almost $250 billion in India, an extra $250 billion. And this is also one of the reasons that the stock market rally has been going up. And it also reflects the confidence of the international community, the investors and all that in the story of the Indian economy. Okay. So that's how you look at things. It's a true reflection of their confidence in the Indian economy from 580 to 825, just one, $825 billion in 1 year. Sonata Finance and BSS Microfinance, both wholly owned subsidiaries of Kotak Mahindra Bank, have approved a scheme of Amalgamation. So Kotak Mahindra Bank is headed by Ashok Vaswani. That's the CEO's name. Ashok Vaswani. Who is the CEO of Axis Bank? Amitabh Chaudhary. Amitabh Chaudhary heads Axis Bank. IndusInd Bank's CEO is Sumant Kathpalia. K-A-T-H-P-A-L-I-A. HDFC Bank is headed by Sashidhar Jagadishan. Yes Bank, you could find the CEOs in the CEO's office. You would find Prashant Kumar. India secured 3 gold, 2 silver and 3 bronze medals at the 17th International Earth Sciences Olympiad held in Beijing. Now, there's not much to discuss here. Actually, when I looked at this question, we barely can discuss anything here. That's what was my first thought. But you look at the choices here. Seoul, Beijing, Tokyo, Oslo. These are capital cities of their countries. But look at choice 5, Bern, Switzerland. Switzerland does not have a capital. Constitutionally, it does not have a capital. There are 2 countries in the world that do not have a capital of, one is the small, tiny, that is a very tiny country of Nauru, N-A-U-R-U, which is about 21 square kilometers, and you could find this in the Pacific Ocean. Nauru has no capital, so does Switzerland. Switzerland also does not have a capital. Okay. Which country has hosted a 3rd Voice of Global South Summit with a theme, an empowered global south for a sustainable future? He has hosted the 1st and the 2nd Voice as well. This is the 3rd time, Voice of Global South Summit. It was held in New Delhi, but it is more of a virtual format. Now let me tell you something about this. About 123 countries participate, and who are these countries? What is Global South? I have something for you. This is it. This comes from the BBC website, this particular graph and this classification. Okay, this line you see here, this defines the Global North from the Global South. It separates the Global North from the Global South. The Global North historically has been seen as rich. The South, Global South, has historically been seen as poor. Okay, now you can see that this line here is called the Brandt line. But who is this Brandt? There was this guy called Willy Brandt. Let's not discuss that guy's name and story. Willy Brandt gave up this story, he drew this line and he said that countries below this line, are historically poor. Now things have changed, of course. India, Turkey, India, countries like Saudi Arabia and all, they are not poor. Yeah, a few countries in South America and most countries in Africa are poor, but that's about it, my friends. But that's how the world is. Okay, you see this there. I found this classification pretty interesting. GNI is gross national income, the total income of all the people of the country. Who would be living abroad also. But if we divide the total income earned by all the nationals of that country living abroad or within the country, you add that by total, you total that number and you divide that by total population, you get per capita income. GNI per capita of what? $1,000 or less, $1,045 or less are low income countries. We are about $2,200. So we become a medium income country. So this is between 1000 and about 12,700. China is about 12,300 something. So high income countries have income of over 12,696. That's quite high. But countries like France, United States, Japan, UK, Germany, they are at a very high level, at a very high level. Yes, okay, by the way, that conference we mentioned, 3rd Voice of Global South, was attended by 123 countries, but Pakistan and China were not invited to this year's event also. Like, they were not invited in the first two times. They were also not invited. Parattu Ravindran Srijesh has recently announced his retirement from international hockey, winning a bronze medal at the Paris Olympics 2024. Parattu Ravindran Srijesh, PR Srijesh, is considered one of the finest goalkeepers of this generation. And Srijesh, my friends, had been in FIH World Player of the Year, Male Player of the Year in 2021, that was the time. And a couple of things more about this great sports person. He is a coach of the under 21 men's national hockey team, under 21 coach. And second thing, he was a member of the team that won the gold medal at the 2014 Asian Games in South Korea and 2022 Asian Games in China. So gold medal twice, two-time gold medalist, Asian Games gold medalist, 2014 and 2022. And then he is also a member of the bronze medal winning team of Indian hockey at the Olympics. The last two Olympics, India had won the bronze medal. And he was part of both on both the occasions, basically. Yeah. So this time it was Paris 2024 and 2020 was Tokyo. Yeah. So undoubtedly one of the greatest hockey stars India has produced. According to an International Labour Organization report, ILO report, globally the unemployment rates fell to 13%. Now this is a 15-year low. See, global growth after COVID has picked up, but the growth has been uneven. Okay, some sectors have done quite well, some regions of the world have done well, but there are some parts of the world where instead of the unemployment going down, it's actually going up. Youth unemployment, basically youth is below the age of 29 for this definition. Okay, people in India, 45 years old, 54 years old, they consider themselves youth icon. Yeah, they are youth Congress leader, youth BJP leader, youth this political party, youth that political party leaders. You would find this in political parties. Okay, I'm not a political guy. I've mentioned all the political parties, but this is how it works. But globally, it's taken to be 29. Cutoff age is 29. Beyond 29, no longer youth. Okay, so the report talks of, in some parts of the world, the growth has been uneven, has not helped at all in terms of generating in employment generation. So what are these places? Arab states, especially West Asia, Southeast Asia and Pacific. Southeast Asia would be Malaysia, Indonesia, Brunei, Philippines, East Timor, those countries. The Pacific, of course, all those Jota Islands like Tuvalu, you have American Samoa, Fiji, Nauru, Kiribati, Marshall Islands, Solomon Islands, all these, they haven't been doing very well, my friends. Yeah. So unemployment here is pretty high, higher than the global average. And second thing, this year, 2024, global unemployment will decrease to even further to 12.8%. So that's 13 this year, last year. This year, 2024, it's likely to decrease to 12.8%. But as I said, this is all uneven. It is uneven. And International Labour Organization was started in 1919. It's the oldest UN organization. It's headquartered in Geneva, which is in Switzerland. And it's headed by a man called Gilbert Humbo. Gilbert, G-I-L-B-E-R-T, Gilbert Humbo, H-O-U-N-G-B-O, H-O-U-N-G-B-O. Gilbert Humbo is a Secretary General. He comes from the tiny country of Togo, T-O-G-O, Togo. Which country? Shall I show you Togo? This is Togo in this map. You see the extreme left here? This is Togo, very tiny country. Yeah. Which country has reported more than 22,000 suspect mpox cases? Mpox, it's called, earlier it was called monkeypox, though it does not come from monkeys. Okay. More than 22,000 suspect mpox cases. Well, DRC. This is the DRC. In yellow, you see here, it's a pretty large country. I think it's the second largest country in Africa. And largest would be Algeria. Second would be this, and third would be Sudan. And Democratic Republic of the Congo, the Congo, basically. Okay. Let's focus on the capitals, because if I give you the names of the countries, presidents and all that, it will only, you know, add to confusion. Like, who heads the DRC? Who's the president? Felix Tshisekedi. Rwanda's president is Paul Kagame. Bola Tinubu is the president of Nigeria. Samia Suluhu, Tanzania. Okay. South Sudan is headed by, what is his name? Salva Kiir Mayardit. I know these names, but I do not want to write. For now, you just write the capitals. South Sudan, this is South Sudan. Okay. South Sudan's capital is Juba, J-U-B-A. It is one of the youngest countries in the world. Rwanda is a tiny country. You can see it here. Yeah, this is Rwanda. The capital is Kigali, K-I-G-A-L-I, Kigali. Then we have DRC. The capital is in one corner here, Kinshasa, K-I-N-S-H-A-S-A, Kinshasa. Then Nigeria. The capital is Abuja, A-B-U-J-A, Abuja. I'm sorry, Abuja. Tanzania. Tanzania's capital is Dodoma, D-O-D-O-M-A. This is Dodoma. Yeah. You can also see the capital as Dar es Salaam. There are two capitals. One is Dodoma, D-O-D-O-M-A. The other, generally, Dodoma is center of the country, more or less, and that's why it's taken. Earlier, it was Dar es Salaam, even though many government offices sit, you know, are still there, localized there. Dar es Salaam. Okay. You see this region here? This is called Horn of Africa. This is called Horn of Africa. It looks like a horn, rhinoceros horn. Which Indian airport has become the first in Asia to receive Airport Council Authority, Airport Council International's highest level 5 accreditation for its sustainability efforts? So, Kempe Gowda International Airport. Kempe Gowda is the founder of Bangalore. So, this is a Bangalore International Airport. Kempe Gowda International Airport is in Bangalore. The first one is in Calcutta. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose International Airport is in Calcutta, Kolkata. Indira Gandhi International Airport, New Delhi. Rajiv Gandhi in Hyderabad. Cochin, of course, Kochi, K-O-C-H-I, Kochi. Okay. Which African nation had officially declared a cholera outbreak? Cholera outbreak. Cholera is a bacterial disease that spreads through contaminated water and food. And you would find this in Sudan. This is Sudan. Okay. We mentioned this is the, Horn of Africa. And this is Sub-Sahara Africa. Below the Sahara Africa. This area. Especially this area. Okay. We mentioned Algeria a while ago. This is Algeria. Pretty large country. Its capital is Algiers. A-L-G-I-E-R-S. A-L-G-I-E-R-S. In fact, Algeria is named after the capital city, Algiers. Nigeria. This is Nigeria. We mentioned Abuja. Sudan's capital is Khartoum. K-H-A-R-T-O-U-M. K-H-A-R-T-O-U-M. Khartoum. South Sudan. Zuba. Z-U-B-A. J-U-B-A. Egypt. Egypt's capital is Cairo, C-A-I-R-O. This is Cairo, C-I-R-O. South Korea and the United States kicked off their annual military exercise named Ulchi Freedom Shield. This is South Korea, which is south of North Korea. This is China, Japan. South Korea's biggest enemies are all three. The biggest enemies, of course, North Korea, followed by China and then Japan. That's in that order. Okay. North Korea. Why don't we write the capitals today? Only capitals, my friends. South Korea's capital is Seoul. S-E-O-U-L. S-E-O-U-L. Seoul. The E is silent. Seoul. United States, we know Washington, D.C. Japan's capital is Tokyo. This is Tokyo. T-O-K-Y-O. Tokyo. Japan has more than 6,600 islands. This is North Korea. The capital is Pyongyang. P-Y-O-N-G-Y-A-N-G. I repeat. P-Y-O-N-G-Y-A-N-G. Pyongyang. Taiwan, this is Taiwan, tiny Taiwan. Yeah, the capital is Taipei, T-A-I-P-E-I. I repeat, T-A-I-P-E-I. Russia, pretty large country. From Europe till here, you can find Russia. And it's ruled from Moscow, M-O-S-C-O-W, Moscow. This is where you find Hong Kong. Hong Kong, S-A-R, Macau, S-A-R. S-A-R is Special Administrative Region. Special Administrative Region. Who is the author of the book, Modi's Governance Triumph, Reshaping India's Path to Prosperity? Tarun Chugh, we'll just pick one more choice. Subramaniam Jayashankar is the author of multiple books. One book is Why Bharat Matters. Why Bharat Matters. Name the bilateral exercise in which the armies of India and Sri Lanka deployed canines, also known as K9, Americans have come about coining this term. Mitra Shakti with Sri Lanka, Nomadic Elephant with Mongolia, Vajra Prahar and Yudhabhyas with America. So 3 and 5 with the US. Choice 4, Maitreyi with Thailand. Which nation will start exporting close to 1000 megawatts of electricity to India? Nepal. Nepal is full of rivers and mountains. That would mean that it can generate a lot of electricity because of hydroelectricity potential. Yeah. The capital is Kathmandu, K-A-T-H-M-A-N-D-U. K-A-T-H-M-A-N-D-U. Kathmandu. This is Bhutan. The capital is Thimphu, T-H-I-M-P-U. I repeat, T-H-I-M-P-U, Thimphu. Maldives, down there, it's not here in the map. Anyway, the capital is Male, M-A-L-E, Male. Myanmar, again, on its, it's the capital is not mentioned here. Naypyidaw, N-A-Y. I repeat, N-A-Y-P-Y-I-D-A-W. N-A-Y-P-Y-I-D-A-W. Naypyidaw. China. China's capital is Beijing. B-E-I-J-I-N-G. Beijing. See, today I don't want to mention the leaders and all this. Yeah, usually I do. Especially in this smart board class. For other reasons, we are using this particular platform today. According to a World Economic Forum report, India lost little under 34 million hectares of land crops due to excess rains between 2015 and 2021. Now, excess rain is always damaging, of course. Anything of excess is bad. Excess lack of rain, excess rains is bad. Both are bad. And, that's why they say moderation is a goal, is a middle path. But, some parts of India have received because of its sheer size. India has varied climatic conditions. Like some parts receive monsoon rain, southwest monsoon. Some receive northeast monsoon. And rainfall is always uneasy. Some regions receive much more than what, normally is. Some receive much less than normal. So I mean, this is a very dicey thing, my friends, but overall things have not been looking up as far as the farmers are concerned because of lack of excess rains and sometimes lack of rains. So much rain has fallen this time. See, I was recently in Rajasthan, and there I found I was in a desert region. And I found Jaisalmer exceptionally green. Can you beat that? In the middle of the desert. Usually it's one of the driest districts in India. Now it is in the seventh wettest district in India. Yeah, I mean, it's been raining havoc there. With which Asian nation did India decide to upgrade its ties to comprehensive strategic partnership? Malaysia. You see that in Malaysia, this is of course in green India. We have Burma or Myanmar, Thailand. At the end of this peninsula, you find this green here. this Malaysia. But here again, this island here, this island is called Borneo, B-O-R-N-E-O. What is the island called? Borneo, B-O-R-N-E-O. Borneo has three countries. Borneo is also, if I'm not wrong, the third biggest island in the world by area. Greenland, New Guinea, Borneo and Madagascar, top four islands. So this particular island is home to three countries. The southern part is, Indonesia. You see Indonesia in one color there. Malaysia, East Malaysia it's called. Malaysia there has the same color as Peninsular Malaysia. And within the Malaysian portion, you'll find this tiny country here where my cursor is. This is Brunei, B-R-U-N-E-I. Brunei is a kingdom, okay? So it's a despotic rule, monarchy basically. Fair? Its capital is Bandar, B-A-N-D-R, Bandar Seri, S-E-R-I, Seri Begawan. Bandar Seri Begawan, okay? Malaysia's capital, there are two capitals. One is Kuala Lumpur, K-U-A-L-A. L-U-M-P-U-R, Kuala Lumpur, and Putrajaya. So India and the Malaysian Prime Minister was in India recently, Anwar Ibrahim. What's the name? Anwar Ibrahim is the Prime Minister of Malaysia. Anwar Ibrahim gets along well with India, but his predecessor Mahathir Mohamad, and in between there was another guy, they were not pro-India at all. But this guy, Anwar Ibrahim, is quite afraid of. His country is afraid of China because China claims this entire region, the South China Sea here. Okay, Malaysia also claims a large number of these islands, and consequently, there is this ongoing tussle between China and Malaysia. Okay, so this is Cambodia. You have Cambodia here. Phnom Penh. You see this P H N O M P E N H. Phnom Penh. Maybe next week, whenever we have a class like this, next class rather, let me bring in something about Cambodia. What happened here between 1975 and 79? Time permits, I'll bring that story in. Okay. Cambodia's capital we discussed, Brunei we know, Bandar Seri Begawan, China we know, Singapore. This is Singapore at the tip of the Malaysian Peninsula. This is Singapore at the tip of the Malaysian Peninsula. Okay, chalo. The following central bankers have been rated A+ in the Global Finance Central Banker Report Cards. All three, the Indian Bank, RBI, Indian Central Bank Governor Shaktikanta Das, Christian Kettle Thompson, who's the Governor of the Bank of Denmark, and Thomas Jordan, who heads the Swiss National Bank. These guys have done a remarkable job of maintaining, controlling inflation and spurring growth. Yeah. Which Indian company has been ranked 70th on the 2024 Forbes Cloud 100 list of companies? Razorpay. See, these are all payment gateways. Payment gateways. They help us, make payments. So they provide the infrastructure to companies, to enable, receiving payments from customers like us. Razorpay was started by two guys, Shashank Kumar, you could write the names, Shashank Kumar and Harshil Mathur, Shashank Kumar and Harshil Mathur. Let's get on. Sanjeev Ranjan will be the new Secretary General of IORA. This is IORA. What is this? Indian Ocean Regional Association. Indian Ocean Region Association. Now the map of India in global maps like this, which is taken from Wikipedia, it would not show, the external boundaries are not true because it shows POK as part of Pakistan and Chinese occupied Aksai chain it shows as part of China. So we just have to do with that. I could have covered it, but I wanted you to know that you should not accept these kinds of maps outset in this session is okay. IORA has a secretariat in Mauritius. You could write the name of the place. Mauritius. M-A-U-R-I-T-I-U-S. Somewhere I just forgot that. Mauritius. M-A-U-R-I-T-I-U-S. Mauritius. This is Mauritius. Here at that very, very, I think I can show you Mauritius. In some other map, I can show you where we saw Africa a while ago. Yeah. This is Seychelles. Oh, it's not there. It's just very close to, just below Seychelles, you would find Mauritius. Okay. Never mind. I think some other map I'll show you. This is Mauritius here and Seychelles here. There are 12 countries. You see these dark countries? Yeah. So EBENE, Mauritius is where the global head office is. Secretary General is Sanjeev Ranjan. He's an Indian Foreign Service officer. You see, it has 12 members. You see in dark green, these are 12 members. Australia, Indonesia, Malaysia, Thailand, India, Pakistan, Iran, UAE, what is this? Oman, Yemen, Somalia, Kenya, Tanzania, Mozambique, and South Africa, plus Madagascar, Okay, from here on, let's look at only the secretariats. SARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. Let me repeat, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation, headed, is headquartered in Kathmandu. Kathmandu is in Nepal. Choice 3, BIMSTEC, is Bay of Bengal. Let me repeat, Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral and Technical, Multisectoral, Technical and Economic Cooperation. Let me repeat. Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral, Technical and Economic Cooperation. Head office, Dhaka. This is Dhaka, Bangladesh. ASEAN, Association for Southeast Asian Nations. Head office, Jakarta. SCO is Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Headquartered, Beijing. I first thought it was Shanghai. I think it's in Beijing. You don't require full guy, you know, the secretary generals. If you still want Chalo, let's write. SCO is Zhang Ming of China. Okay. Next. ASEAN secretary general is Kim Horn, H-O-U-R-N. He is from Cambodia, C-A-M-B-O-D-I-A, Cambodia. His full name is Kao Kim Horn, but enough, Kim Horn is fine. BIMSTEC, Indramani Pandey. Next choice, one, SARC. SARC is headed by a Bangladeshi diplomat called Ghulam Sarwar. Ghulam Sarwar, S-A-R-W-A-R. Which institution or bank has issued the world's first carbon removal bond to the tune of $225 million to fund Amazon reforestation? So carbon dioxide, this is all destroying excess carbon footprint. This is destroying the planet. And Amazon is kind of lungs, they form vital lungs of the planet Earth. But rampant deforestation has damaged, the forest. in a big way. So now Amazon reforestation, who's funding it? This entire project, World Bank. You look at World Bank, it's headquartered in Washington DC. New Development Bank, headquartered in Shanghai. Asian Infrastructure Bank, headed in Beijing. Asian Development Bank, Manila, M-A-N-I-L-A. Manila is the capital of Philippines. India's second home built a 700 megawatt nuclear power reactor at Kakrapar Atomic Power Station in Gujarat has started operating at its full capacity. India has about 23 nuclear reactors across eight nuclear plants. Okay, about 20 to 23 nuclear reactors across eight nuclear plants. And we have a total installed capacity of 7,380 megawatts. Together, nuclear energy comes to contribute about 3.1% of total energy production in India. 3.1%, yeah. Which Arab nation has recently joined its BRICS counterparts in signing a pivotal declaration to launch a Center for Industrial Competences? The United Arab Emirates. This is the UAE. These are all BRICS nations. Okay, shall I read the names? Brazil, what is it? Brazil. So in the Americas, there is only one, Brazil. In Africa, earlier there was South Africa. Now there is Ethiopia, two new members. Ethiopia, E-T-H-I-O-P-I-A, Ethiopia. And look at this, Egypt, what is it? Egypt, E-G-Y-P-T, Egypt. Egypt. Then United Arab Emirates, then Saudi Arabia, it's not full actually, Saudi Arabia, then Iran, Russia, China, and India. Thank you for being here. Have a lot of fun. Do write in to us at info@timeforeducation.com. Let me repeat, info@timeforeducation.com. Thank you for being here. Thank you so much. And please stay curious.